Okay, so I'm here with Andy Parnell, and Andy, you just got done presenting on Rolls-Royce, and I wanted you just to share a little bit about Rolls-Royce with the folks that weren't in your presentation. You talked a lot about how it's a little bit different than people may know, some of the new industries you guys have been in. So.
Sure. Well, as you're probably aware, Rolls-Royce is a growing business. It's very dynamic. We've moved into a lot of new business areas. And it's very important for us that we maintain our integrity, our reliability, and our ambition to be very agile in all the technology we develop. However, the challenges of modern business are such that it's a complex business, working in marine, in civil, military, and also in energy. It gives a lot of big challenges that, you know, one of the things obviously we've implemented is PLM systems, and that enables us to develop the technology in a more capable way, in a more efficient way, and to be sort of respondent to the needs of the customer.
And you guys share best practices across those industries, so you learn from one another? And
that's right. Obviously, we try and work close with other industries such as Red Bull and also JCB to share, you know, knowledge, techniques, methods, processes, to try and understand how we can be more agile and give the customers better service at the end of the day.
So you deal in a lot of complex industries, and you talked a little bit about trying to simplify the complex enterprise. Tell me how you do that with all that you guys have to deal with, legacy data-wise, et cetera.
Well, it's always a challenge, and you quite rightly say legacy data is a big issue for us. We've got a vast array of data, you know, dating back many, many years. I mean, aero engines, for example, typically have been in operation 25, 30, even up to 40 years. And that generates a lot of data, all of which has to be searchable, it has to be, you'd be able to find issues if they occur in service. And we're trying to address that by, you know, having good systems that are labels to search that data, but also by simplifying the various sort of products that we generate, and by reuse of components, materials across our entire sort of complete array of products.
Okay. And so at the same time you're trying to simplify that business, you're also preparing for growth. So I think at one point you talked about going from 4,000 users today to maybe 30,000 in the future. How do you structure for that?
Yeah, I mean, basically Rolls-Royce has been a very successful business. I think we've seen rapid growth over the last few years. We've not really been significantly affected by the downturn in the economic climate. And we're seeing great success in selling our products into the business. So things like XWB for the A350, for example. There's been a massive sale of those different products, and therefore we have to scale our business appropriately to deliver. So we're growing at quite a rapid rate, and it's really growing in a measured way. We have to enable the processes to grow dynamically, and also to ensure that we support our customers as equally well now as we hopefully do in the future. So it's really about how we do all those things in a sensible manner by using things like PLM and a lot of other tools in actual fact in the business as well. It's really about empowering the people to actually support that activity at the same time.
Yeah, you emphasize a lot on people and investing in organizational change management. So that seems
that's right. I mean, obviously, the people basically are the ones that use this technology. If you can't sell that to them, can't get them involved, get them to buy into it, you will never, ever extract the goodness from that technology. And it's really about selling it to them. It's getting them involved, getting them to take part in the entire sort of development process and the deployment process of the new capabilities.
One other thing you touched on is that at any point in time, there might be 400,000 people up in the air that are flying in an airplane that has one of your engines.
Yep.
And you guys obviously recently have had to deal with things like volcanic ash. I'm just kind of curious, how do you deal for this changing world and that kind of volume that, you know, is dependent on your products?
Well, you quite rightly indicate that obviously volcanic ash was a big problem for us earlier on this year, and no doubt will be in the future. But we have to take that on board with all the other environmental constraints we have to deal with. There's lots of things that we have to develop our products to meet in service. And volcanic ash is no different from that point of view, whether it be sand, whether you're flying across the Sahara, or volcanic ash. And it's really ensuring that through our product validation exercises and the engine verification, we test our products to ensure that they're as robust and reliable as we possibly can make them. We'll never address volcanic ash completely because it's quite a difficult sort of substance to deal with, but we do our best and we try and ensure the integrity and reliability of everything we do.
Okay, great. Thanks, Andy.
Okay, thank you.